in the quarter of an hour or so that you folks have been picking a soft drink or a snack or talking to family and friends. Almost a year has passed on stage. Roy has moved into a little farmhouse at Pearl's insistence. Pearl had insisted that when she and Roy take over the reins of Pa, she's a very insistent person, then and only then would they move back into the palace. Roy has been very accommodating. But who have we here? Why, it's Guruji. And Pearl and Roy. What a coincidence.
Oh, look, Roy. Look, it's Guruji.
Hi, Guruji. Come, sit here. I'll get you a nice glass of fresh milk.
No, not this time. I'm on my way to meet someone. I had to pass your place. I thought I'd drop in to see how you're getting on.
Well, we have growing pains, semi-serious disagreements, him throwing my past at me. He won't let me carry pails of milk. Says it will spoil my queenly poise.
Guruji, she is wonderful.
Of course.
And she doesn't mind helping me out in all those dirty work and taking care of those sheep. And she doesn't care. She doesn't mind being mugged up as well. You know what?
So nothing serious. You both have adjusting to do. And young life thrives on things like that. You don't need any my help to solve that. That reminds me, a little bit told me that Prince Machismo is heading this way. I think he's coming to meet you, though he would never admit it.
Maybe I should stay.
No, Roy. The prince I need to have a long overdue talk.
I'm sure he would not do any harm to princess. But Pearl is right. You and Prince need to have a clarificatory talk. Since you have rejected his offer last time, come Roy, I would like to have a word with you before I go to my next meeting. Be gentle with him, Pearl. He's afraid.
Afraid of what?
Princess, what are you doing here?
Why not? This is near where I live.
Oh yes, I guess I must have forgotten. Yeah, that's it. See, I associate you with the palace and...
Prince!
Didn't kind of realize that you might be living here.
Machismo, what are you afraid of?
Afraid? Oh, me? I'm afraid of no one. I'm a macho man. I keep myself fit. I don't need any bodyguards or anything of this sort.
You know what? I know what you're afraid of. Mr. Macho Man, you are afraid of your own self.
What?
So you're running away all the time from the person you think you are, trying to be someone else. You're no different from what Wolfie was in the first part of the play.
You are comparing me to Wolfie? That crazy mixed up animal.
You are another version of the same. You don't think that you are deep down any worth. So you're running away trying to convince everyone that you're someone else. Get in touch with the real you, which is probably not so bad as you think. Be who you really are. Cut out all this football, badminton, hockey, and yeah, boxing crap. Wake up, man. Be yourself. Be real.
How dare you? How dare you talk to me like that? Do I need to remind you that I'm Prince Machismo of Moderno?
If you want to pull rank, I'm the daughter of an emperor. And that the reason I have to claim to tell you what I believe to be the truth? It is plainly and simply because I believe it to be. That's my sole right, or anyone's sole right, to say anything at all. So whether you agree with me, wish to listen, or get offended, all that is beside the point. And now that I've said what is my right and duty to say, bye.
This is unbelievable. No one has ever spoken to me like that before. And what does she know? A mere girl. What a man is like. I guess it's all my fault for letting myself into conversation with a female all alone. I must not let that happen again. A young man and a young woman should never meet apart from others and speak to each other alone. It does no good.
My prince, don't worry. I'm not what you would call a young girl anyway. I always said that sort of thing until recently. All this easy fraternizing the sexes didn't seem right to me once. I always believed that young people, especially boys, were ill-equipped to handle such direct exchanges. You chaps are always so uncertain and in hurry. You're ready to whistle to a girl who passes by, but if she stops and addresses, you get panic, you feel afraid, and you get cold feet.
Not me. I'm a macho man, I'm an athlete, and...
Yes, yes, and appearances are deceptive, and you really are a big, bad wolf. You're actually more scared than the average guy. That's why you have to dress up to yourself. Why try to hide such a nice doggy that you are? Maybe the real you is far more acceptable than you think.
How dare you talk to me like that? I'll have you remember that I'm Prince Machismo of Moderno.
So sorry, Your Highness. I thought you would be unafraid of truth and reality.
What nonsense. I don't really have to listen to all of this.
Thought you would be unafraid of truth and reality? Now that's nice. Coming from me. Talk of the pot calling the kettle black. I really... Good day, gentlemen.
Good day.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
He doesn't seem to like us.
Very perceptive of you, I must say. But let's do the point. A little bird told us that this Prince Machismo was here somewhere.
What are you two asses doing here? I thought you were busy planning a counter-attack.
Yes, dear. Of course, dear. Perfectly correct, dear.
And that's why we are here, ma'am.
We received an intelligence.
That Prince Machismo was here in the vicinity.
Intelligence? From a little bird, I suppose.
Yes, dear. Of course, dear. Perfectly correct, dear.
And so we thought that we'd fix something for him quick. Or else his parents will raise this royal stink and they definitely don't want to go back home with a bachelor boy in their hand.
And what misbegotten, idiotic and rotten eggs are you hatching?
Nothing yet, my darling. We were about to start. But with the superior intelligence working with us, we
were... Cut that stupid drivel. Flattery will get you nowhere. We have to find a match for the prince to marry. Some eligible female in the vicinity.
The problem is that all the eligible female are on stage and backstage are either fixed up or else married.
What about trying to find somebody in the audience? That girl in the second row there?
You blithering numbskull! With the brains of cockroach that was dropped on its head by its mother soon after birth. It's the one thing to dissolve between audience and caste. It's quite another thing to encourage intermarriage beyond that dive.
Yes! There are limits to postmodernism.
Yes, dear. Of course, dear. Perfectly correct, dear. Your superior intelligence has saved the day once again for us.
Where is my superior intelligence had gone when I agreed to marry you? Is anyone's guess? I thought
I'd be able to further career in Europia with bit of push here and prod there. But underestimated the depth of your stupid, bubbling, alleged brain.
Who can we get married this prince much as more to? Let's see. Barbara and Little Bird.
Yes.
Nah. We can't get Prince Machismo married to animals. It is a female human that we are looking for.
Well, at least one of you is beginning to emit the faint signs of slowly emerging intelligence from evolutionary process.
I have got it. I have an idea.
Congratulations.
My sweet loving wife, I have an idea as to whom we can marry off the prince.
Don't tell me. Let me guess. Mistress Pradanti Seema. She looks and old enough to be his grandmother.
He'd really have to be desperate to settle for that old hag.
No! I was thinking of the narrator! Yes!
The narrator? She's a character all right. But is she a character in the play?
But much less, she's a member of the audience. That's actually a brilliant idea, Pompey.
Thank you.
Great. You two, don't just talk about it. Do it. Bring my husband's brilliant idea to fruition.
I have told you that I have been grossly underrated and underpaid.
Pompey! She called you Pompey? Wait till I tell the entire gang.
If you tell anyone, I'll make sure that's the last thing you'll ever do.
Okay. All right, let's do the business. Narrator. Narrator!
What? Don't tell me. I missed one of my cues.
No. Nothing of the sort. In fact, you're doing a fantastic job with your part. Superb characterization. Excellent delivery. What do you say, Sage?
Unparalleled! Out of the world! You are surely going to be the nominee for SSU Dramatics Awards 2022.
Something's fishy here. You hauled me on stage to congratulate on my acting. There must be something to that.
You are accusing us of having ulterior motives? How could you?
Pure as ribbon snow. Butter wouldn't melt in our mouth. We were just showing appreciation to the great artist.
Exactly. And now with a performance like that, you deserve the best, a royal reward.
Deserve the best? Royal reward? Are we getting to the point at last?
And so what if you're a commoner or something? But this is modern egalitarian age.
Exactly. Many princesses have married commoners.
Come to the point. Or I'm going off stage this very minute.
A prince machismo? Doesn't he strike you an extremely handsome and dashing young man like me? I mean, Hrithik or something?
So, we knew that you liked that guy. The other day, Prince Machismo, he was just confiding. We were just 2 beers down.
Sage, old friend.
We're just 2 beers down.
And he's like, this narrator, she's quite a dish.
He told me even more than that. You know, we often play tennis and snakes and ladders, you know. And in the context of Solomon male bonding, he wanted to be in a relationship with you, if you would be interested in it.
I do not believe this. You know, it looks like You both are trying to proposition me on behalf of Prince Machismo.
Certainly not. Exactly, that's what we're trying to do.
You are interested, aren't you? You like him, don't you? Mm-hmm. The very first time I saw you when you were looking at him, you arched your left eyebrow and you were like, I knew that this girl has got a glad eye for that handsome hunk. You like him, don't you? And I read women like books.
I've never heard anything so impertinent and presumptuous in my entire acting experience. First of all, I'm convinced you're making all of this up. Prince Machismo didn't ask you to do any of this. And if he actually did, then that's worse. If you really understood women, as you claim to, you should know that hardly puts a girl off as a guy who asks intermediaries to plead a case with her. If a man doesn't have the guts to speak to her and make his proposal, he won't be man enough to hold his end of the relationship. You can tell him from me.
See, what another nice mess you've gotten me into?
Not a bit. You don't understand women, Pompasito. They always play hard to get. Now that I have put that silly idea in her female brain, now wait for it. It's like a time bomb. It is just going to blow. If we just give a little bit of nudge and a little bit of push to Machismo in the right direction, he is going to fall in love with the Narita.
Good to hear. Things were just brightening up a little bit. Now that you guys are here, we'll be back to bed as before.
No one really appreciates what we try to do for the mankind, Sage. But that's how the world is for the world's greatest saints.
That's life, my friend, that's life. But did you hear what Prince Machismo said? He said things were looking bright. Things were looking bright. Prince Machismo, I and Pomposito were discussing about soul good of yours. And we had this heart to heart, this intense conversation about you and Narita.
The Narita?
Yes.
So you thought nobody had noticed? But I did. I'm perceptive. I can read men like books. And I can see that you have absolutely gone battle over her.
You are both out of your minds. I don't even remember what she looks like.
Didn't fool me. I can see into his eyes that he has absolutely gone bananas over her.
Pomposito, at least use some romantic expression for such things. What has gone bananas over her? Gone bananas or whatever. Would you two be kind, just plain and simple, just be gone? Mistress Prudentissima and I need some privacy for a chat, and it's too crowded off stage.
Mostly revered Guruji. So that's why she's here? Interesting. At this 2 hours from the vicinity of privacy? What do they want privacy for?
You know, Pomposito, I can read women like books. And I can see that she has a glad eye for that Guruji.
Huh? as you can see, how he pronounced her name. You know, Sage, you never know these things because no lady has ever gone bananas over you.
Yeah!
Ow!
Ow!
Ah, I did like to say, basically they are good fellows, but for their stupidity.
Providentially, Guruji. They are so stupid that whatever mad plots and plans they come up with, they actually end up neutralizing with their frustration and bumbling.
That's true. And it lands me into a particular problem. I, who am supposed to have committed my life to help people attain the truth about themselves, find myself sometimes tempted to leave them in their errors. As in that way, they did be less harmful to others.
Seems the right thing to me, Guruji.
No, the truth, the real truth makes one a freer and a better person too. But we didn't come here to discuss about those jokers.
No, Guruji, we are here because I wanted to talk to you about myself, about my pursuit of truth, about myself. Maybe I should ask myself how serious I am about that pursuit.
And you have a reason to doubt your honesty with yourself?
Yes, Guruji. Somehow watching how much is more apt, noting his insecurities, and especially the walls that he built between himself, his real self, and the opposite sex, and above all, the challenging things that I told him a while ago, all these made me realize that he was nothing but just a less subtle form of myself, and all that I said to him, above all, meant for me.
That was very percipient of you, Mistress Prudentissima. But what he and you are running away from? What are you afraid of?
Ourselves, Guruji, ourselves. Just look at me, for instance. My very job of being a chaperone. I've made a profession out of tagging after young girls to prevent them cultural exchange with boys of more or less the same age. A kebab mein haddi Princess Pearl called me.
And this led you to ask deeper whys?
Yes, Guruji. I asked myself, why does Prince Machismo always go for his sports stuff? And why, of all the professions, have I chosen to become a chaperone?
And did you get an answer, Mistress Prudentissima?
Well, I think I have. Right now, as I talk to you, things are falling into place. I think it's because I know. It's because I'm afraid. I'm afraid of talking to people, to the opposite sex. I was afraid that they would reject me offhand, especially now. Just look at me, all old, bent, and ugly, before my time.
If attitudes can bend you up before your time, then changing these attitudes should be able to rejuvenate you.
You really think so, Guruji?
Of course. We aren't so helpless against the circumstances. Remember, the truth is that you have, the real you comes to the fore only when someone discovers it and loves it. And we all are lovable. You, me, Prince Machismo, all of us. But only that we wouldn't pretend to be something that we are not in order to become lovable.
Oh, Guruji. Guruji, tell me what to change so that I can find my real self, my really lovable self, as you say, so that I can show it to the world for someone to love. Really lovable, Guruji.
Of course you are. The real you is. It's the false selves that we put on that repel others. Be convinced of your lovableness and let your real you come to the fore.
I'm lovable and I can reverse the aging process in me drastically and magically by just changing my attitude. But who will love me? Guruji? Guruji? Gone? Without so much as a bio leave? That's so unlike him.
Where is
he gone?
I don't see him here. Are you playing a joke on me, little bird?
I normally don't communicate with subhumans.
No. I never said that Guruji wanted to meet you here. I merely said that he wanted you to be here. That's all he told me to tell you.
But really, what's the point of having me here when there's clearly no one around? Mr. Studentissimo, you are still here?
My prince, I owe you an apology. All that I said to you about facing reality, about not playing with life, well, turns out it applies more to me than to you.
No. Please don't apologize. What you said to me applies to me perfectly. See, I've taken your advice and not thrown all my sports masks, taken to wearing normal clothes again. When you spoke to me, I was mad at first. To be honest, I couldn't take that truth told to me by two members of the opposite sex. A sex which, according to my silly ideas, were inferior of body and mind to us macho men. But you made me do some critical thinking. Now, I'm to stop all this play acting to be a macho athlete and try to rediscover my real self. I even took off my boxing gloves to switch more in keeping of a guy my age.
Oh, that's wonderful, my prince. I'm really, really happy for you. This clearly means that you really are very, very brave and deep. I really am very happy for you. Guruji was right. He said that we could change ourselves by changing our attitude. And if I may be so bold to say, you're actually much more attractive.
Oh, why, thank you, Mr. Studentissimo. This confirms me in my resolve.
My prince, do you think that I could also change myself by changing my attitude? Guruji said I could.
Well, of course you can, Mr. Studentissimo. The truth does make us free. It hurts quite a bit at first, but once I accepted what you said, I felt a more fuller, more confident person. I owe you so much. In fact, I owe my life to two girls who told me the truth. You and Pearl, who helped me become myself again.
My prince, you can't call me a girl anymore, whatsoever be my age. See how old and ugly I have become with my sick attitude.
No, Prudentissima. That doesn't have to be like that. I'm sure the real Prudentissima is somebody beautiful and lovable. If you only let her come to the fore.
What are you doing?
Just trust me.
Oh.
Just take my hand.
No, no, no.
Trust me, take my hand. We'll see. Rediscovered your real self. And if I may say, you are really beautiful, Pranjusuma.
Thank you, my prince. Thank you for making me beautiful and setting me free.
No, Pranjusuma, you set yourself free. And by the way, my name is Machismo for you. Pure and simple. And actually, I think it is love that set us both free.
So, it worked.
Guruji.
I am so glad for you both.
Thank you, Guruji. Thank you.
Don't thank me. Thank each other. For it didn't take much insight to realize that both of you were right for healing from each other.
Oh, Guruji. I'm so happy that I could sing.
So why don't you? Maybe the prince can join in too.
Sure, why not?
Looking back at yesterday, I thought I gave it everything. But still there's so much road ahead of me.
When I look into your eyes, I guess I didn't recognize who we are and all that we can be.
Sometimes it's hard to find yourself, but it's worth it in the end. 'Cause in your heart is where it all begins.
You gotta be bold, you gotta be brave. Be free. You gotta get loud, making that change. You gotta believe. Whoa, we look deep inside. We rise up and shine. We can be bold, we can be brave. Let everyone see. It starts with you and me.
Special that I've learned is together we can change the world. Everybody's got something they can bring.
When you take a look inside yourself, do you wish that you were something else? But who you are is who you need to be.
Sometimes it's hard to find yourself, but it's worth it in the end. 'Cause in your heart is where it
you gotta be bold, you gotta be brave, you gotta be free. You gotta get loud, making that change, you gotta believe. Whoa, oh, we look deep inside.
Well, folks, it's time. I reminded you that this is a modern parable. You can also take as the story of the SSU. Crippled for 3 years under COVID, is loved and resurrected by youth and lovers of youth into being young, hale, and hearty again.
We thought you were with Prince.
Actually, we received an intelligence that Prince Machismo had found an eligible partner, what are you doing here all alone?
Yes, as soon as we heard that, we came here running right here to ensure that we saved our skins and
we just wanted to know if Prince Majismo found you.
Oh, I'm quite sure the prince has found a partner. But we mustn't rush things. Give them time to savor the beauty of it as it grows. Nature always moves slowly but surely.
It worked!
Yes, it worked!
You must agree that my brilliant plan has worked, Sage.
Your plan? It was all my idea. And the way I sneaked into the wheels of this woman.
It was all due to my deciphering of the enigma of masculine mind. Now Mulgatani
is going to pay us handsomely.
Yes. No doubt about that. Look at each other's names. They have three syllables. Ma, Chis, Mo, Na, Re, Ta. They sound like wedding bells. Ma, Chis, Mo, Na, Re, Ta.
Not a word. You ask us to hurry here. Say, you had something to tell us? This had better be good.
Have you or have you not? A simple yes or no. Did you find a partner for our son?
Yes, I have, Your Majesties, I have.
You have? What do you mean? Kera kaam, kera na?
Yow!
Good for you that the answer is yes. The Emperor and Empress will be showing up soon, and we intend to show them her. Who is the lucky young lady?
She is the most accomplished and eligible young lady.
The cynosure of the audience's eyes most of the time.
She better be. I won't have my son married off to a minor part player.
Actually, she's not exactly a character in the play, but...
You mean she's in the production team? I'm not having my son married to an unskilled laborer.
No. She is a very important character, a key mover.
Enough of this beating about the bush. Her name, please.
It's the narrator, Your Majesty.
The narrator? But she is neither here nor there, neither flesh nor foul.
It's almost like marrying to someone in the audience.
Where is he anyway? Let's hear what he has to say.
As a matter of face, there is a two girls in the fourth row.
But Your Majesties, you know what this modern of youngsters is like? He'll want to make his own choice.
You mean he wants to marry this narrator thing?
Yes, Your Highness, yes.
Just like banks and money.
Or milk and honey.
How did he choose her of all people?
There one quick way of finding out. Little bird.
Someone call.
Can you tell us where's the sun?
You know whom we are talking about? Prince Machismo of Moderno.
Oh, him. He's out kitschy-cooing with Mrs. Prudentissima and all that sort of thing.
What? My beloved son is taking up with an old hag off back? That's look twice his age.
I'm with a face that could sour milk. Is this some kind of a joke?
Don't you tell me that. There's a call-up again.
But it's not possible. Only if you had the lid in the narrator's voice.
And the way her eyes batted every time she saw him.
Yes.
There's only one quick way of finding this out, folks. Narrator.
Now what? What are all of you doing here? I don't think this is in the script.
Answer a question in one word. Yes or no?
Are you in love with our son, Prince Machismo of Moderno? Has he proposed to you? When's the wedding? No to all your questions. And there's no wedding being planned for me and him. Now, as regards to him and Prudentissima, that's quite another question.
You lied to us?
You made our son pair with that hag of back that's looked twice his age? He will be the laughingstock of Utopia Moderno.
How did you choose to?
How did you choose her of all people?
You must have bewitched the poor boy. You, Sage, must have given him some drug. I'll kill you for thus.
What have you done to our son's future? At that of Moderno, you slimy toad.
Please, Your Majesty, leave something for me. Don't finish it off.
What's happening?
Oh my goodness.
What is this?
Machismo?
I almost didn't recognize you.
Prudent Isma, you look so young and beautiful, younger than our son.
Well, I am. I just looked old before because of my attitude.
And we are to be married. Of course. We will consent to you.
With all our heart.
Well, glad to hear that, Mom and Dad. But we weren't asking for your consent. We're just informing you of our plans.
Take it. Leave it. There it is.
Oh, Pompey.
Now, my darling. My sweet, loving wife. Not in front of these people. Family quarrels should be private affairs.
Oh, Pompey. My poor, wonderful man. You have saved the day. My poor, wonderful man. You overawed by the efforts he has made to ensure your son's happiness.
And don't forget about me. It was all me who, alone and unaided, guided Prudence to Seema to become her real self.
What? No. Nothing of the sort. It was I who counseled both Machismo and Prudentissima using the latest technique of transitional analysis. How dare you take all the credits for yourself?
Yo!
Actually, it was Prudentissima who set me free with a little of preparing on the way from Pearl.
Actually, it was love that set us both free, and in our case, Guruji helped us speed the process a bit. Not you, Sage.
Oh, look. Here come all the characters. It must be time for the grand finale.
We and all come together. You can either stand up or stand, come and stand next to me.
Right.
My prince, you look wonderful.
And Princess Simash, you look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Even though it is not unexpected, we are always surprised at the effect of love. Prudentissima and Machismo, you are the best advertisement I have ever seen for the miracle of love.
And since we are on the issue of love and all that sort of thing, just want you all to know that Barbara and I are going to get married.
Murphy, this is all so sudden. But of course, I'll marry you.
Well, that's it. We've come to the end of the play. Yes, Sage, I haven't forgotten. You can make a final, profound remark before we all pack up and move on. We can't stay here forever. Neither you nor us. Okay, Sage, you're on.
Yes. Well, there are two types of people in the world. Ones who stay and ones who go.
No, there are two kinds of people in this world. Those who know where they're going and those who don't know where they're going.
No, there are three kinds of people in this world. Those who can count and those who can't count.
Be that as may, one thing is certain, whether you can count or not, you certainly do count for all your friends who love you.
And if you guys want to become a part of us, we meet at Parish Hall every Sunday, 6:30 p.m. So do join us.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for coming today to watch The Pearl. We would like to thank a few people who supported us throughout this production. First, we would like to thank Father Patekar for providing us with the Gulati Hall at a moment's notice. The parish priest, Father Jody, for allowing us to use the parish and Barco halls for our practices. And Father Raja for his infinite help to us during this production. Next, we would like to introduce and thank the production team of the play. The first one being the accounts team headed by Sadaf Pierboy, along with Candice Pandit. The second department being the design team headed by Munira Faltanwala, along with Ankush Gupta and Pulak Mishra. The third one being the choreography department headed by Tushar Patil. The next one being the music department headed by Leander Jacob along with Dwij, Ayush, Ompia, Janice, Mithali, Shruti and Chelsea. The next one being the sets and decor team along with Ashutosh Mengde as the head of the department. The next is the costume department headed by Treta Lulla along with Munira. The next one being the marketing team headed by Shakti Prasad Patra. Along with Alfonso, Hussein, and Munira. The next one being the advertisements department headed by Chelsea Miskata along with Amit and Ashutosh. The next is the passes department headed by Munira Faltanwala along with Nikhil and Isha. The next one being the prompters team headed by Candice Pandit. Along with Sadaf. The next one being the makeup department headed by Treta Lulla. Along with Disha, Aditi, Preeti, and Akansha. The next one being the sound and light cue, headed by Leander Jacob, headed by Nikhil, Julian, and team. Then last one being the videography team, headed by Jayaprakash Parkhe and team. And lastly, we would like to thank the playwriter and director of our play, Father Cyril De Brule.
The last one being the producer, Nikhil Lemos and Munira Faltanwala. Thank you.